I'm often asked as an author, where did you get the idea for the book? Very often I don't know, but in this case I actually did. I was driving back from Cape Cod to New York City, and we stopped off to get a hamburger, and on the way back to the road, my wife said, look at that road sign, that will mean something to you. And I glanced over at the road sign, and it said Breakheart Hill, which is, of course, in a sense, the French translation for Breakheart Hill. And by the time I got to New York, about 2.5 hours later, I knew the entire story. I knew the characters, I knew where it would be set, I knew everything about it. And I thought that this book would be probably one of my most passionate novels. They all aren't the same. As I often say when I'm in a group or when I'm speaking, that writing a lot of novels is like having a lot of children. If the truth be told, you don't like all of them the same. And some of my books I like, and some of them, frankly, I'm not that crazy about, especially the early ones. But this is one of my absolute favorite novels of myself. I poured my heart into it. I wanted to write about how political passion and the passions of romance can combine in a particularly volatile way. And so this is set in the South, the Deep South, the small town South in 1962, at the very height of the Civil Rights Movement, which plays very much into the plot of the story. It remains essentially a love story, but it's a love story with a historical dimension. And it's also about time, and it's about regret. And it's about looking back on something that happened years and years ago from the perspective of age. We often say that life, the first life, should be rehearsal. And if we could do that, then we wouldn't make the same mistakes. And this is about a book about a man who essentially is trying to do that. Truly and frankly, looking back into his life over 40 years to see, in a way, what went wrong. And since so many of us, in fact, do that, I suppose I would say that this book is the closest book that I ever wrote to having an actual universal theme. I hope you will enjoy it. I think you will. I think to say that what inspires writers and to expect that there be one thing that inspires them is probably a mistake. Some writers write for money, but most actually write for reasons that are somewhat deeper than that. For me, it always comes to something, an internal interest, a deep sort of spiritual interest in whatever the human topic is. It may be betrayal, it may be sacrifice, it may be courage, it may be cowardice. But it really is an effort to explore some theme within human life. I think that's primarily the inspiration for most of us. For some, though, it's a bad childhood that they can never get over, or a bad marriage that they can't get over. And some people write about drugs and what it did to them. Some people write about alcoholism and what it did to them. And those are all inspirations for those people. But I always go back to the notion that the Greeks had, that the purpose of literature is moral instruction. What you're really attempting to do is to say to others, don't do this. This is a mistake. Try to correct your course before it's too late. That was the old Greek notion of the purpose of literature. And I think for most people, it remains essentially their inspiration.